Jesse. So today I want to show you how to connect your Music on Hold system to a IP office control unit. And I just want to remind you that it is important to have Music on Hold on your system because it gives you a chance to tell callers about yourself, you know, about the services and products that your company has, and testimonials and honors that you guys have, things like that. So advertising is expensive enough as it is. So here we have the On Hold Plus 8000 that we're using today, and it comes with a 128 megabyte flash drive. That's you can use up to 2 gigabyte flash drive if you want to, but this one normally would be big enough for most companies. So you just want to install that on the side there. It's just like a regular USB port. You can cord that comes with the unit. There's actually two cords that come with the unit. This is the 3.5 millimeter jack that's on the back of the IP office that comes right with the unit for you. You plug in this side, plug in the other side to the port that's labeled audio on the back of your control unit. And just plug in the power from your power supply. And the volume actually is also the on-off switch. You can turn it on with that. And start it up here. So if you want to test it out, you can place a call from one phone to another, or if you already have a short code set up for Music on Hold, you can dial your short code, which I have set up. And you hear that it's fine. And the impedance setting on the USB On Hold Plus unit should be set to 8 ohms. If your Music on Hold is not working on your system, you can check to make sure in the manager program that it's set to external. And I'll show you on the computer here if you need to know how to do that. If you're connected with manager, you can click on system on the left over here and then select your unit. If you have more than one unit, then go to the telephoning tab at the top, then click on tones and music. And then on the bottom here, you'll see hold music, system source. If it's set to WAV file, just change it to external. And then click on OK, and don't forget to click on the icon at the top that looks like a disk to save your configuration back to the system. And that's basically all there is to it. You should be happy and ready to go. Thanks for joining us.